Hello everyone, welcome to this session on muscles of the upper limb. In this session we'll be learning about the scapulohumeral muscles. So these are the list of muscles which we'll be learning in this session. As the name suggests, they connect the scapula to the humerus. These are also referred to as muscles around the shoulder. Okay, so these muscles are deltoid. Then these four set of muscles, subscapularis, supraspinatus, infraspinatus and teres minor. These four muscles are included in rotator cuff. Rotator cuff of the shoulder, also referred to as the musculotendinous cuff of the shoulder. Okay, and there's one more muscle, teres major muscle. So these six muscles will be covering in this particular session. So let's start with the deltoid muscle first. So any muscle, as we all know, when we study, we have to cover under particular headings. So these are the headings. We should know the proximal attachment of the muscle, the distal attachment of the muscle, the nerve supply of the muscle, and lastly, the actions of those muscles. Okay. So for deltoid, proximal attachment is from three regions. Because there are fibers of the deltoid. This is the anterior fiber of deltoid. These are the middle fibers of deltoid. These are the posterior fibers of the deltoid. Okay. Since there are three different set of fibers, these three fibers originate from three different parts. Okay, the anterior fibers of the deltoid, they arise from the clavicle. The middle fibers of the deltoid, they arise from the lateral margin of the acromion. And the posterior fibers of the deltoid, they arise from the lower lip of the spine of the scapula. Okay, then distal attachment or the insertion of the deltoid is over the anterolateral surface of the humerus. There's a deltoid tuberosity, which gives V-shaped attachment to the deltoid muscle. Okay. Then nerve supply of deltoid muscle. Nerve supply is by C5 and C6 spinal segments. The name of the nerve is axillary nerve. Okay. So axillary nerve supplies deltoid muscle. There is one more muscle which is supplied by axillary nerve. That muscle is teres minor. Okay. Axillary nerve is a branch from which part of the brachial plexus? It's a branch from the posterior cord of the brachial plexus. Okay. Then actions of the deltoid muscle. Deltoid muscle is the chief abductor of the shoulder joint. 15 to 90 degrees of abduction of shoulder joint is done by deltoid muscle. Okay. 0 to 15 degrees is done by supraspinatus muscle. 15 to 90 degrees is done by deltoid, and beyond 90 degrees it is done by the upper and the lower fibers of the trapezius acting along with the serratus anterior muscle. Okay. And the middle fibers of the deltoid, they are chiefly responsible for abduction of the shoulder joint. Okay. The middle fibers, there's a specific type of muscle fibers here, which is referred to as multipinnate fibers. As the anterior and the posterior fibers of the deltoid, those are unipinnate fibers. There are different actions for the anterior and the posterior fibers. The anterior fibers are responsible for flexion as well as medial rotation of the shoulder joint, whereas the posterior fibers are responsible for lateral rotation of the shoulder joint. Okay. So whenever we speak about actions of the deltoid muscle, you have to speak about different actions of the different set of fibers of the deltoid. Abduction is chiefly done by the middle fibers of the deltoid. Okay. Now let's look at some dissected images of the deltoid muscle. These are the anterior fibers of the deltoid. This is the middle fiber of the deltoid. And in this image, we are viewing the deltoid from the lateral aspect. Here, these are the posterior fibers of the deltoid. Okay. This is middle and this is anterior. Okay. If we carefully look at the shape of the deltoid muscle, it is somewhat like this. It resembles an inverted Greek letter delta. Okay, that's why the name is deltoid muscle. And there is one important applied anatomy related to the deltoid muscle. The intramuscular injections are given in the deltoid muscle. It is most preferably given in the lower aspect of the deltoid muscle to avoid injury to the axillary nerve, which winds around the surgical neck of the humerus. Okay. So now let's cover the next muscles. So subscapularis muscle. The proximal attachment of subscapularis muscle is from the subscapular fossa, the anterior aspect of the scapula. That there's a shallow depression which is referred to as subscapular fossa. The fibers go laterally to get attached here. The distal attachment is over the lesser tubercle of the humerus. Okay. Nerve supply of subscapularis muscle is by the upper and the lower subscapular nerves. Root value is C5 and C6 from the posterior cord of the brachial plexus. Okay. And actions of subscapularis muscle is, since the fibers are running like this and they are inserted over the lesser tubercle, when this muscle contracts, it will rotate the humerus medially. So in turn, it will lead to medial rotation of the shoulder joint. Okay, so subscapularis is the chief medial rotator of the shoulder joint. Here we can see the dissected image of the subscapularis muscle. This muscle is subscapularis. Okay, fibers arising from the subscapular fossa running laterally to get attached onto the lesser tubercle of the humerus, and when this muscle contracts, it will lead to medial rotation of the humerus, in turn leading to the medial rotation of the shoulder joint. Now let's cover the remaining four muscles: supraspinatus, infraspinatus, teres minor, and teres major. All these four muscles are seen along the posterior aspect of the scapula. The supraspinatus muscle, it arises from the supraspinous fossa. So proximal attachment is from the supraspinous fossa, and distal attachment is over the greater tubercle of the humerus. In the greater tubercle of the humerus, there are three impressions: upper impression, middle impression, and lower impression. So upper impression is for supraspinatus, middle impression is for infraspinatus, and the lowermost impression is for the teres minor muscle. Okay. So greater tubercle of the humerus, we can remember a mnemonic: SIT, sit. S for supraspinatus, I for infraspinatus, and T for teres minor. Okay. So supraspinatus, proximal attachment, distal attachment I've covered. Nerve supply of supraspinatus is suprascapular nerve. This arises from the upper trunk of the brachial plexus. There was one more nerve which was arising from the upper trunk of brachial plexus. Which nerve was that? Nerve to subclavius muscle. Okay. Then actions of supraspinatus muscle is, it initiates the abduction. 0 to 15 degrees of abduction is done by supraspinatus muscle. Okay. Then infraspinatus muscle, it arises from the infraspinous fossa. Muscle goes laterally and to get attached onto the greater tubercle of the humerus, the middle impression. Okay. Then nerve supply of infraspinatus, it is again the same, that is suprascapular nerve. Okay, suprascapular nerve supplies supraspinatus as well as infraspinatus. The course of suprascapular nerve is such that it comes from here near the suprascapular notch. It will supply supraspinatus, and then it will come here downwards. This region is referred to as the spinoglenoid notch. From the spinoglenoid notch, the nerve comes downwards, and then it will supply the infraspinatus muscle as well. Okay, that's how we can remember suprascapular nerve is for both muscles, suprascapularis as well as infraspinatus. Then action of infraspinatus muscle, since the muscle is going like this and getting attached onto the greater tubercle of the humerus, when this muscle contracts, it will lead to the lateral rotation of the shoulder joint. Okay. Let's cover the teres minor and teres major muscle. Teres minor and teres major, these both muscles, they arise from the lateral border of the scapula. The upper 2/3 of the lateral border is teres minor, and the lower 1/3 of the lateral border is teres major. Here we can see a small gap near the origin of the teres minor. This gap is due to the circumflex scapular artery, which winds around the lateral border of the scapula. Okay. Teres minor, distal attachment is over the greater tubercle of the humerus, the lowermost impression. And teres major, it goes on the anterior aspect to get attached onto the medial lip of the bicipital groove. Okay, bicipital groove, as we all know, the lateral lip gives attachment to the pectoralis major, the medial lip gives attachment to the teres major, and the floor gives attachment to the latissimus dorsi muscle. Okay, so this was about the attachments. Then nerve supply of teres minor, I've covered in the deltoid muscle. Axillary nerve also supplies one more muscle, that is teres minor. And nerve supply of teres major is lower subscapular nerve. Okay, lower subscapular. Upper and lower subscapular nerve, both nerves were supplying the subscapularis muscle, but the lower subscapular nerve also supplies teres major muscle. Okay, then action of teres minor will be similar to infraspinatus, lateral rotation of the shoulder joint. Then teres major muscle, since it is going on the anterior aspect, when it contracts, it will lead to medial rotation of the shoulder joint. Okay, medial rotation is teres major, lateral rotation is teres minor. This was about these four muscles. Here we can see book image. This muscle is supraspinatus, this muscle is infraspinatus, this muscle is teres minor, and this muscle which is cut, this is teres major muscle. Okay. Now let's look at some dissected images of these muscles. So here we can see the posterior aspect of the scapula with the muscles. This muscle is supraspinatus muscle going laterally, getting attached here near the greater tubercle of the humerus. This is the spine of the scapula. Below the spine of the scapula, this muscle is infraspinatus. Okay. And this muscle which we can see here, this is teres minor. Teres major muscle is not shown here. It is seen in this image. This muscle is teres major. Okay. And this muscle which we can see, this is actually the long head of the triceps brachii muscle. This is long head of triceps. So now let's summarize what we have covered in this session. We started with the deltoid muscle, the proximal attachment of deltoid, the anterior fibers of deltoid, it arises from the anterior border of the lateral one-thirds of the clavicle. The middle fibers of the deltoid arises from the lateral margin of the acromion. The posterior fibers of the deltoid, it arises from the lower lip of the spine of the scapula. Distal attachment of deltoid is on the anterolateral surface of the humerus. There is a rough elevation which is referred to as deltoid tuberosity. Distal attachment is on the deltoid tuberosity. Nerve supplies by the axillary nerve. The root value is C5, C6. Action, deltoid is the chief abductor of the shoulder joint, 15 to 90 degrees of abduction. And anterior fibers of deltoid are responsible for flexion and medial rotation of the shoulder. And posterior fibers of deltoid are responsible for extension and lateral rotation of the shoulder joint. Okay. Then subscapularis, supraspinatus, infraspinatus and teres minor. These four muscles are included in rotator cuff of the shoulder, also referred to as musculotendinous cuff of the shoulder. Subscapularis arises from the anterior aspect of the scapula, from the subscapular fossa. And these three muscles, they arise from the posterior aspect of the scapula. Supraspinatus arises from the supraspinous fossa. Infraspinatus arises from the infraspinous fossa. And teres minor, it arises from the lateral border of the scapula. The upper two-thirds of the lateral border is teres minor, and the lower one-thirds of the lateral border is teres major muscle. Okay. Subscapularis muscle, distal attachment is on the lesser tubercle of the humerus, whereas the supraspinatus, infraspinatus and teres minor, these three muscles are attached onto the greater tubercle of the humerus. Okay. And teres major is attached, distal attachment is on the medial lip of the bicipital groove. Okay. Then actions of supraspinatus. Supraspinatus is responsible for initiation of abduction. The 0 to 15 degrees of abduction is by supraspinatus. Infraspinatus and teres minor, they are responsible for lateral rotation of the shoulder joint. And teres major is responsible for medial rotation of the shoulder joint. Okay. So these six muscles we have covered in this session. So if you all have any doubts, then you all can ask in the comments section below. Okay. Thank you.